everybody had an ocean across the USA. Then everybody'd be served like California. You'd see them wearing their baggies, Huarache sandals too. A bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, serving USA. You'll catch them surfing at them
inside, outside USA.
Ventura County.
Hi, this is Ken Kaplan from the New England Motorcycle Museum, and today I'm proud to represent probably the cleanest 1975 SXT125 I've ever seen. This is about as close to NOS brand new as you're ever going to find. This bike has 119 miles. I think most of that was being pushed around the museum or in and out of the various storage places it's been in since it was brand new. This bike has been in storage or in museum condition for a long time. By that I mean there was no fuel in the tank for quite some time, and the engine was actually, the previous owner was wise enough to not just fog the engine but fill it full of oil. The exhaust pipe and the engine was filled with oil and then kicked over so that there would be virtually no degradation of the quality of the metal on this bike. So that's the condition it came to us in. We did quite a bit of work, preventative maintenance on the motorcycle. I'll go over everything that was done to it. The bike's in perfect working order, as you saw in the video. It's a lot of fun. It's a gorgeous looking bike. It's a 40-year-old motorcycle. It's all original, the paint, the AMF Harley-Davidson paint, the graphics, the tires. It has the original Pirelli tires on the motorcycle. The seat cover is in beautiful condition. That's about as fine of a 1975 seat cover as you'll ever find. The again, these are the original Pirelli tires with 119 miles on them. No dry rot on the tires, indicating the area of storage was proper. It wasn't left in the sun or anything. So the patina on the bike is limited because of the way it was stored and the way it was cared for. And the engine is impeccable on this bike. I'll go over some of the stats on the engine in a couple minutes. And it's all original. The bike's never been dropped. It has original levers on it, the original brake lever, original throttle grip, original Harley-Davidson branded mirrors. These are the original mirrors. They actually say Harley-Davidson on the stock if you look right here. These are the original AMF Harley-Davidson mirrors. These are not cheap Chinese repos or repops or anything like that. I believe these are the original tie class for the wiring harness. All the cables are in mint shape. There's no cracking on the top here on any of the cables. The throttle cable, brake cable, clutch cable. One of the items we did replace on the bike is the turn signals. These are all four turn signals on this bike are brand new, just mounted this week, NOS Arimachi turn signals. Good luck finding another set of them, and they're in impeccable condition. The original ones had some patina on them. and they were in less than perfect condition, and we had these accessible to us. They're worth hundreds of dollars, and they're brand new. Really adds a little bit to the bike. One of the other things I want to point out, very common on the Armachi 125s, is the airbox on them has a wing nut that you tighten down, and most people over tighten it and crack the airbox case, which is very, very common. It doesn't mess with the integrity of the intake system, but it cosmetically takes away from it a little bit. This bike has a brand new NOS airbox and air filter assembly, so that is brand new. So when you get this bike, if you ever service the air filter, do not over tighten the air filter, because it's very common on this particular model to crack the air box. And if you look on eBay, one just sold for $734 for the air box alone. Parts are very expensive for these bikes. This one needs nothing. This is a museum piece. It belongs in a museum. It is on display in the New England Motorcycle Museum right now today. It's being sold along with some other fine classic antique motorcycles to help pay for the restoration cost of the museum. So the serial number on the bike is, the VIN is 3F1234 3H5, indicating it's 1975 SXT125. Truly a museum piece, 117 original miles. I doubt you'll ever find one this nice anywhere, and maybe the finest of its kind in the world left. Certainly here at the museum, we've never seen a nicer one. And this color just pops. This is an off-road motorcycle, but it is street legal. It has the upswept pipe. And if you heard the way the engine runs, it's crisp. It's fast. I rode the bike. You'd be surprised at the acceleration. I'm 225 pounds, and it hauls the mail with my big butt on it. Traditionally, the two strokes have power equivalent to a four-stroke, double its capacity. So it's got horsepower and torque similar to a 250 four-stroke. Fantastic bike. We put about 23 hours of labor into the bike, and I'm not sure I have the right parts number. It was somewhere around $985 in parts. Is that with the airbox also?
Yep.
That was with the airbox. Okay. So we just put $2,865 into the bike, and I'll go over with you what we did to the bike. We did a full 20-point inspection on the bike, top to bottom. I wanted to point out the condition of the bottom of the engine and the frame rails. Take a photo underneath there. You're going to see the bottom of the engine is absolutely freaking immaculate. The frame rails have no dings. This bike's, in my opinion, as far as I know, it's never touched the dirt. And that's indicated by the condition of the bottom of the engine. When we got the bike here, I'm going to break it down into intake, engine, electrical, and overall condition, the items that were serviced on the bike. Full service, full detail, and a professional museum quality wash, wax, and polish by the detail pros at the New England Motorcycle Museum was done on this bike after it was taken out of its mothballed state with the engine full of oil. First thing we did is we took the fuel tank off the bike, and the fuel tank was flushed and cleaned, and you can see it's in fantastic condition. The tank has never been coated or anything like that. We do not coat tanks. We don't recommend doing it. We use an acid etching process where the tank is acid etched and then rinsed out and then rinsed with fuel. The fuel that we use is VP C12, and it's a non-ethanol fuel. So the fuel tank is flushed. We put a brand new petcock on the bike. As you can see, it's a brand new petcock, brand new fuel lines. And so the whole intake to the carburetor is like new. The carburetor was removed and completely cleaned in our ultrasonic carburetor cleaner, then adjusted to optimum specifications. That's why it runs so good. There's a brand new oil pump cable adjuster was installed, and the throttle cable and oil pump cable were both lubed, and then the free play was adjusted, so it's perfectly adjusted to the exact precision amount of oil that should go into it. The oil injection system, the tank was drained and flushed, and new two-stroke oil was added, and the injection system was then bled to ensure continuous lubrication and tested. As I said earlier, a brand new OEM airbox was installed due to the little bit of dried out rubber and a crack on the airbox, which is very common. That item just sold on eBay for $734. We bought ours for about less than half that. Does have a brand new complete intake system on, with the carb completely rebuilt and the tank Petcock, everything is perfect. That's it for the intake. Your intake system's as good as brand new. The engine was completely fogged with oil, as we said, so the engine was completely drained. The exhaust pipe was removed. We drained all the preservative and oil out of the engine and exhaust, and the flywheel cover was removed, and the flywheel was inspected and cleaned. The engine, they actually took the engine out of the frame to inspect it thoroughly, and also to turn it over while it was upside down to make sure there was no oil residue left inside the engine. So it was coated with a assembly lube and oil, but not enough to foul a plug. So it was, you know, thoroughly cleaned and lubricated. Probably the smartest thing that you could ever do with a motorcycle you're gonna park is fill the top end with oil in the lower end, and that was what was done to this one. So that's why it runs so good. That's why it's as good as the day it came out of the box. The engine was reinstalled. The transmission oil was drained, and new transmission oil was installed. It's 80 weight transmission oil. The cylinder was then given a compression test, yielded a perfect 140 PSI, as you would expect for a brand new motorcycle, and a brand new NGK spark plug was installed. The point gap in timing was adjusted to the perfect optimum level. The engine was started, idle speed air fuel mixture and screw adjuster were tested, and it was road tested. So that's it for the engine and the intake as you have it. Everything's perfect, torque to factory spec. Not a single bolt on the bike is rounded off or mauled or marred in any way. All services were performed by a Concourse AMA championship winning motorcycle restoration expert here at the New England Motorcycle Museum. Regarding the electrical components on the motorcycle, a brand new YB7LB battery was installed. It's a top of the line battery. And all four turn signals were replaced with brand new OEM signals. Hard to even put a price on that. Not the stalks, but the actual turn signals themselves are all brand new. Look at the chrome on them. Look at the lenses. Look at the bulbs. Brand new. Where are you going to find a set of those? They're worth hundreds of dollars for sure. They're priceless if you can't get them, right? So the battery leads in the terminals were completely clean, and the charging system was checked. All electrical connections were cleaned. Everything works perfectly. All proper functions of all electrical functions were tested. All the lights, the headlight, the turn signals, the brake lights, everything works perfectly as it should, as you saw in the road test. Overall, final drive chain slack and rear brake pedal play was adjusted to spec. The chain was clean and lube. If you take a look at the chain, this chain looks brand new. Why? Well, the bike only has 117 miles on it. So the chain is just, you know, as you expect a brand new chain to be. There's a little bit of patina on the sprocket. That's, you know, it's a 40-year-old sprocket. It is aluminum uncoated. So there's a little bit of patina there, which is appropriate for the finish of this motorcycle. Like I said, the paint job on the fenders and the tank is all original. The bike then, once it had a final test ride, performed to ensure the proper operation of the clutch, transmission, and brakes, and everything was 100% perfect museum quality and operating condition. The bike received a full detail, including the hand wash, wax, steam clean, and overall detail work performed to the bike to put it in the original mint shape that you see right here. So just to summarize, brand new battery, brand new spark plug, brand new transmission oil, brand new two-stroke oil, brand new air box assembly, brand new fuel petcock, brand new fuel lines, and four brand new turn signals. And the full detail done on the motorcycle. So quite a bit was done to ensure this bike, it's 40 years old, but it's 100%. And you will not find a nicer, cleaner one. Now you might find a restored bike, but you're not gonna find an original that's 117 miles like this one. There is a little bit of patina. Gorgeous as the bike is, it's 40 years old. It has a little bit of the original patina you'd expect in a 40-year-old bike. There's a little bit of a stain on the tank here from some, maybe a gas stain or something. We didn't try buffing that out. We only put a Mother's California Gold Carnauba paste wax on it. We didn't want to tempt fate and try to buff that out and mess it up. There's also a tiny little ding in the tank right here, which a dent magician could probably pop out. We're selling it as is. That dent was left, that little tiny ding was left in the tank, but it's hardly noticeable when you look at the bike. So again, the bike is a, let me just go over some of the specs here. It's a two-stroke, single cylinder, air-cooled bike, 123 cc's, The rating is a 125, but it's 123, 10.8 to 1 compression ratio, and it's rated at 13 horsepower. However, I believe the seat of the pants feels stronger than that to me, and it certainly has a lot of torque because it'll pull out of the gate in third gear, no problem. A lot of torque because it's two-stroke. So I think I summarized pretty much everything here, the labor that was put in the bike. A couple things I'd like to tell you. The SXT-125 is equipped with an aluminum cylinder with a hard-coated barrel. It's a Nicosil-style coated barrel, and the bike has a separate button. So what does that do? Well, aluminum cylinder is lighter, it dissipates heat better, and the hard-coated barrel lasts a lot longer than just a standard iron bore. This bike also has a separate plastic reservoir for two-stroke oil, so you don't have to mix the gas and oil. It's mounted beneath the gas tank. And there's an automatic oil pump for the oil mixture, which we talked about earlier. It's fully adjusted with a brand new cable adjuster. And that's behind the cover on the right side of the engine. This is the oil injection pump inside of there. So just a fantastic bike, rare piece. This is a new model. The SX was replaced in 1975 by this bike, this SXT-125. It's a little bit different color scheme, and it had a pressed steel heat shield on the exhaust. And the logo on the heat shield consisted of the needle and a fragment of the American flag in the inscription, 125SX, really kind of a cool looking flag, kind of iconic. One other thing I wanted to point out here is, hopefully you've stayed with me this long. If you are, you're very interested in this bike. This is the title to the motorcycle. It actually has a title, which is something most 40-year-old motorcycles don't have. Definitely adds a lot of value, especially if it's getting exported to the UK or overseas or wherever. There's your title. And I also have included is the 1975 owner's manual for the SXT-125. This is the original manual that goes with the bike. Very desirable, very expensive, very valuable manual. Price these out online, you'll see they go for a stupid, ridiculous amount of money. I've seen some manuals sell for hundreds of dollars. I've even seen one listed for $1,200. Don't know if it's sold, but certainly you get a lot of money for the literature. When you get a bike that's this nice, to have the title, to have the literature, to have it fully certified, to have been tested and demonstrated by the New England Motorcycle Museum adds value to it also, and the fact that it is a museum bike on display. I hope it goes to a good home. If you have any questions, give us a call at 860-454-7024. If you have any questions about the bike, you did get a picture of the bottom of the engine to show them, right? Take a look underneath the rear fender right here. Look at the condition of the original paint underneath the fender there. Absolutely immaculate. You're not going to find, these bikes were designed to be ridden off-road. This one wasn't, not only not ridden at all, it's got 100 miles on it, but it wasn't, certainly wasn't ridden off-road. If you look underneath the front fender, same thing. Everything's the original patina, original paint is all intact. The gauges are crisp and clear. Look at the gauge. It looks like it just came out of a box. The fit and finish on the bars, the ignition key, the brakes and levers, there's no wear on those components. So the kickstarter, even the rubber on the kickstarter, is immaculate. We have another one of these with 600 miles on it. That one, you can see the rubber is all like kind of worn out, so from being kicked so many times. But this one is only been started a handful of times. So I hope it goes to a good home. If you have any questions, again, give us a call. All proceeds from the sale are going to the New England Motorcycle Museum Restoration Fund. So I'm gonna go ahead and push this baby back into the museum so people can admire it until it goes to its new home. So good luck bidding on it, and God bless.